still trying to turn. They keep losing members. Faker tries to go to the back as Ignar stops him with what he can, and the turnaround is happening.
What's up, everyone? Zyrene here. This week on The Breakdown, we're going to take a look at the series-turning fight in Game 4 of the quarterfinal matchup between SK Telecom T1 and Misfits. There were three small but key moments that had an enormous effect in how SKT were able to stunt the engage, reset the fight, and turn it around. So let's get into it. 27 minutes into the game, Misfits are up 4,000 gold and just use Hansama's On the Hunt to kill SKT's jungler Blank. And with a temporary 5v4, Misfits look to push their advantage and utilize their composition's strength in turret dives. This may seem too aggressive, but diving here is perfectly fine. They have two large tanks with Warmog's armor to heal back up, and Alistar, who has rank 2 Unbreakable Will, which makes the damage from turrets almost non-existent. It's also important for Misfits to keep the pressure up, because they have a mono-threat composition with a supportive mid laner that will eventually fall off in the face of SKT's tank shred and scaling. As Misfits deal damage to the mid lane turret, SKT look to contest, and Huni walks up. If Misfits can kill Huni, they could potentially push and end the game, or at the very least, take the middle inhibitor and then use this large minion wave top lane to get that inhibitor as well. So Misfits begin a dive that should be a piece of cake, but the devil is in the details. Huni is behind and has yet to fully complete a defensive item, so Misfits look to chain their crowd control and kill him before he can respond. Alfari slows Huni with Vorpal Spikes and begins stacking Sejuani's Frost passive. As Huni retreats, Alfari uses Feral Scream to silence him, preventing the use of Flash, Pillar, or Subjugate. Maxlord then lands two hits of Winter's Wrath as Alfari knocks Huni airborne with Rupture and feasts on him, dropping him to 168 health. The instant Huni is free from CC, he casts Subjugate onto Maxlord Sejuani, immediately healing him for 465 HP, giving him resistances and a heal over time. Dropping a CC chain is usually the result of a misplay, but in this case, it was actually disrupted. Huni manages to walk away with the help of Wolf, and the way Wolf plays this is the first key moment of the fight. Wolf waits until after Alfari's Rupture goes off to cast Stand Behind Me onto Huni because he doesn't want to be interrupted in transit, and as he leaps to Huni's aid, he puts up Unbreakable. This blocks the damage from both Hansama and Power of Evil, but more importantly, it ends up being the crowd control combo breaker. Sejuani's Permafrost stun requires the target to have 4 stacks of her Frost passive, and then she can activate the ability to stun and attack the target to shatter them for an extra percent of their maximum HP. Because Sejuani's Permafrost is her throwing an axe of ice to stun the enemy, it is considered a projectile. As Maxlore casts Permafrost onto Huni, it is intercepted by Wolf's Unbreakable, and it stuns him instead. This means Huni won't take the follow-up 15% maximum HP damage, and more importantly, it breaks the chain of CC, giving Huni a moment to cast Subjugate, and it prevents Misfits from killing him. Wolf also buffered his ultimate, and because the ability can't be stopped once it's been started, he completes the cast of Glacial Fissure while stunned, and it knocks 4 members of Misfits into the air and creates a zone that slows the backline's advances. The member not knocked up by Wolf is Ignar. He could have contributed to the CC chain of Misfits, but instead he's looking to jump onto SKT's clumped carries. Ignar casts Flash, Headbutt, and Pulverize onto Bang, knocking up Bang, Faker, and Huni. But Bang's reaction is our second key moment of the fight. Ignar went for Flash Headbutt because it's much harder to react to, but Bang is still able to input a perfectly timed buffer on his rocket jump. In the time it takes Ignar to travel with Headbutt after flashing, Bang gets a basic attack off and just barely reacts to Ignar's flash by rocket jumping away at the last possible moment, perfectly timing the buffer to nullify both parts of the Alistar combo. As Bang jumps to safety, SKT are now in a position to turn the fight. SKT want to separate Misfits' frontline and deal damage to tanks first. Step 1 here was the Glacial Fissure from Wolf, slowing Misfits as they advance. Step 2 comes from Huni, who throws down a Trundle Pillar and provides a 45% slow for 6 seconds, creating a choke point between the pillar and the wall and the pillar and the turret that Misfits must funnel through to continue this fight. As Hansama, Power of Evil, and Alfari are now all slowed to reinforce Ignar's dive, Maxlor and Ignar find themselves in a temporary 2v4, and Faker's execution in SKT's swap to aggression is the third key moment of this fight. Ignar uses the stun from Trample onto Faker, which he instantly cleanses. Maxlor drops, and now Faker is ready to chase. As he pursues Misfits, Alfari silences, and a second later throws down a rupture that would normally be unavoidable. But Faker's cleanse has a lingering effect, granting 65% tenacity for 3 seconds. This drastically lowers the duration of Alfari's silence from 2 seconds to 0.7 seconds, and Faker can now avoid the knockup with Flash and continues slinging spells, finishing off both Han Sama and Ignar with a mid-fight Realm Warp. The rest of SKT chase down Power of Evil and Alfari and complete the clean 5-for-0 ace in a situation that was a 4v5. Looking back, Wolf saved the series by protecting Huni just long enough with his Unbreakable, absorbing the damage and intercepting the stun. And although Wolf single-handedly put the brakes on Misfit's dive, the rest of SKT used that opportunity to turn the game around with their clutch mechanical play. And Faker's abilities were on full display. It's not just that he was quick and showcased his finesse with fluid spellcasting, he also showed his mid-fight decision-making when he seamlessly swapped from defense to offense and placed a Realm Warp mid-combo. Because of this miraculous turnaround, SKT would even up the gold, take the game, and eventually the series 3-2 over Misfits. SKT move on to the semifinals to face Royal Never Give Up, keeping the SKT dynasty intact and the dream of a three-peat world championship title alive.